Hello and welcome to the Mobalytics Patch 11.24 tier list. Hope you've been having a blast in the preseason getting used to all the changes. I'm Danox Harrison and there's been a ton of adjustments on 11.24, so let's get stuck straight into breaking them down. Under the top lane, in the God tier, we have Dr. Mundo, Teemo, and Tahm Kench. In the S tier, we have Garen, Jax, Malphite, Nasus, Sett, Shen, Urgot, and Yorick. Top lane has seen a few changes. First and foremost, Lethal Tempo got a minor reduction in the attack speed per stack. It's still offering enough to be a huge amount of power, but this brings it a bit more in line. Frostfire Gauntlet also got a nerf to the damage it applies on hit. It no longer scales with health and has a marginally lower base amount. This still puts it in a stronger spot than before preseason, but means tanks won't be 100 to zeroing you quite so quickly. Cloud got a big change in which Skarl's HP now counts as base HP and not bonus HP. This is a hugely negative change that hurts his interaction with Titanic Hydra and other items that scale with bonus HP. To mitigate this, there has been buffs to Skarl's HP late game, his E cooldown and ratio, but ultimately these changes look disastrous and he's dropped down below B tier. A big one is Conqueror getting a buff. It lands exactly halfway between where Conqueror was before its nerf, so it's looking like he'll be in a decent position, especially as his rune was still really solid for bruises. Camille also took a nerf from this patch, with extended cooldown on her E later and reduced power on her W. She is a menace at high-ELO, which is what this is meant to address, but it has just resulted in her suffering even more at lower ranks. Onto our highlight picks, first up is Jax, and he's one of the strong utilizers of Lethal Tempo. He's able to really quickly stack it up and win extended trades effectively. He's a solid pick into a bunch of the competitive top laners, and with Lethal Tempo being strong and Conqueror getting a buff, he's a great answer which scales well into the later stages of the game. Jax's ability to stick to a target allows him to utilize the sustained DPS offered by Lethal Tempo and decimate in longer fights. You have solid side laning options, and if your team falls behind, you can look to take turrets and claim objective bounties to get back into the game. Mundo is an absolute brick wall. He's able to lane safely and farm from a distance with his Qs, and his innate sustain and lack of mana means he's fairly comfortable withstanding pressure. He quickly ramps up as the game goes along, and if ahead he becomes borderline immortal. Even with Frostfire being nerfed, it's still a great mythic, and the extra damage and autos added in the preseason helps you smash down on anyone you get in range of. Nasus has for a long time been a low elo stomper. We've all seen the games where he stacks his Q up to insane levels and decimates everyone, but a big factor in his strength is his W Wither. The attack speed reduction heavily shuts down champions who are auto-reliant, that's a great deal of the top laners you'll face into. Fleet Footwork helps you survive trickier lanes with a lot of harass thanks to the extra sustain, and the movement speed will help you stick onto targets. Your ult is a huge power spike as you'll get bonus health, MR, armor, attack range, and shred your opponent's HP, but on top of all that you also get a reduced CD on your Q. In most lanes your all-in is dictated by playing around your ult, and a lot of champs will struggle to match you with it up. Next, onto the jungle. In the God tier, we have Master Yi, Trundle, and Vi. In the S tier, we have Amumu, Graves, Nunu, Rammus, Shaco, Warwick, Xinzhao, and Zac. Jungle didn't see too many changes. Biggest would be the nerf to Predator, which essentially reverted the earlier buffs. There wasn't too many champions capitalizing on this rune, at least not at lower ranks, and most, in cases of picks like Hecarim, have strong alternatives that were performing pretty well. Ivan got a pretty substantial buff with an increase to the experience and gold he receives on Krugs, and prior to this it just wasn't worth taking Krugs, and with First Scuttle being nerfed it made it a pretty big pain to hit level 4 as Ivan. On top of that, Ivan is a great utilizer of the new Glacial Augment. He can apply it with both his Q and with Daisy's knockup, allowing him to be even harder to get away from. The scaling for Glacial Augment is really solid with bonuses to healing and shielding, which syncs extremely well with Ivan's build path and does benefit from the boost from Moonstone. This allows you to apply a very high percentage slow with Glacial Augment, ensuring your targets will struggle to move out, even if they have high tenacity to shorten your root duration. Nunu is just a menace at lower elos. With less value on early scuttles, he can invest his time into ganks, and he's incredibly hard to avoid, particularly so in the side lanes. Nunu benefited from the buff to Sunfire, which helps him become incredibly bulky, but he still has the same trait of being really difficult to escape. Immobile champions in particular don't have much counterplay once he starts running them down with the snowball. In the later stages, your opponents are able to cut through you better with penetration items, but you still do a ton of work with zone control thanks to your ultimate, and your ability to secure objectives is always relevant. Rammus has found a really potent combo by combining the new chem tank with Dead Man's Plate. Both items in unison give him a large amount of movement speed, but they also empower your first auto to deal huge damage. A big aspect of Rammus is not only his ability to gap close onto a target with his speed, but also the damage he can output to easily 100-0 a target in his taunt, and this allows you to do that more consistently. With Conqueror buffed and Lethal Tempo still looking strong, Rammus is in prime position to shut down any auto attackers he goes up against. Onto the mid lane, in the God tier we have Kassadin, Viktor, and Lux, and in the S tier we have Akshan, Anivia, Annie, Fizz, Vex, Yasuo, and Yone. Mid lane has seen mages rising massively in terms of power thanks to items like Crown of the Shattered Queen and a bunch of powerful mage itemization choices. We are seeing them getting toned back down now. Crown has lost 10 AP, which is pretty negligible, but Cosmic Drive took a pretty heavy hit all around. We do see, however, Archangels get a 400 gold cost reduction, which is really nice, as even with it being a bit underwhelming, it was still being built at the 3000 gold cost point, and the cheaper price point makes it much more desirable for the champions who've lent on it. First up is Anivia, and she's thrived with the booster AP items. A cheaper Archangels is a great addition to help her hit her spikes better, and she scales extremely well. With the meta leaning a bit later thanks to the comeback mechanics of objective bounties and the lack of emphasis on first scuttle, Anivia is popping off. In late game teamfights, your zone control is really difficult to play around, as between your ultimate and your wall, you can cut off a huge section of terrain and make navigating around it a chore. Kassadin is one of those champions that ramp up like a swelling wave, and eventually he hits critical mass and becomes almost unstoppable. He's benefited massively from the reduced emphasis on first scuttle, which he kind of sucked at contesting, and also with the comeback mechanic introduced with objective bounties, he's really in a solid spot. As a big bonus as well, he's enjoyed the buffed mage itemization, and in particular on this patch, the reduced cost of Archangels makes a massive difference in him hitting his item spikes sooner to access his late game power. We all know Kassadin needs levels as well, but combine that with your core items and you're golden. Cassiopeia is another benefactor of the improved mage items. Crown of the Shattered Queen has been a great pickup to allow her to survive burst engages and turn things around with the Miasma and Ultimate. With Archangels being cheaper and not only providing her with a ton of mana, but also boosted sustain, she's functioning well as a bruiser once more. The cherry on top is the fact that we're seeing Conqueror buffed and she was still using it even after the nerfs. With this buff, you can function really well as an AP bruiser and just shred through your opponents. Onto AD carry, in the god tier we have Misfortune, Vayne and Jhin. On the S tier we have Ashe, Caitlyn, Jinx, Sivir, Swain and Ziggs. AD carries have seen really limited changes on this patch. Samira had a mana cost removed on her ult at level 6 and 11, and this really doesn't do too much to change her power, it's simply a nice quality of life change. Lethal Tempo had its attack range bonus nerfed by 25 for ranged champs, but in return receives an extra 2% attack speed per stack, meaning it now grants 42% at max stacks instead of 30%, which is honestly a positive change for longer range champs like Jinx and Caitlyn, but does offer less strength for champions who are heavily relying on the range like Vayne. Caitlyn not only got the benefit of the lethal tempo changes, but a big buff was they've re-added a partial auto attack reset whenever she autos an enemy marked by her traps or nets. In a bug fix a few patches ago, we saw this mechanic removed and it's resulted in her feeling incredibly clunky, so this change is likely to offer a solid power increase. Caitlyn is very much a lane powerhouse, but a long range combined with the utilization of lethal tempo allows her to be a menace in the later stages of the game as well. Jinx is another champ who has thrived by utilizing lethal tempo. The extra attack speed granted on this patch allows her to ramp hugely with the rockets and dominate in later game teamfights. With objective bounties, all it takes is one big teamfight win to bounce back from behind, and Jinx is a monster in the later stages if she has some gold. With a single reset, you can dominate, and the stacking effect of lethal tempo is not only powerful, but syncs so well with the increased range of your rockets. Last but not least is support, and in the god tier we have Sona, Lux and Soraka, and the S tier we have Blitzcrank, Morgana, Nami, Zilean and Zyra. In the support role, we've seen a couple of changes. First up is Evenshroud was nerfed with the damage increase and duration being lowered. This item was really allowing melee supports to flourish, and this is definitely a decent dip in their power. In solo queue at the moment, enchanters are really delivering, so the fact we've seen melee supports nerfed just puts enchanters on an even bigger pedestal. We also saw Glacial Augment have the base slow nerfed by 5%, but in return got a pretty significant boost to the scaling, which overall puts it in a good spot as the game goes further and further. It's not necessarily good on every champion, as Guardian and Aftershock are still powerful tools for melee supports, but the ones who can utilize it are excelling. Morgana has been doing solidly as an answer to your standard melee engages for a while now, but she's been really popping off with a new Glacial Augment. The duration of the slow is extended by the length of the CC, and with Morgana's binding being so long, it allows you to control a huge area with the keystone. On top of that, once you land the binding, you can keep them slowed down so you can easily approach and secure your ultimate for an AoE stun. Add on your black shield to block engages and CC, and Morgana is really thriving in the right matchups. Zyra is a great teamfighter, and right now teamfights are super important with the power introduced by the new souls and the comeback ability from objective bounties. Landing a big ultimate allows you to cover a huge area and decimate the opposing team. In lane, you can harass consistently and you pair well with the longer range AD carries like Caitlyn and Jinx, which we highlighted in this video. The one concern with Zyra is getting popped by assassins, so be really cautious about face checking or a Talon will delete you. Enchanters have been super dominant recently, and with Evenshroud nerfed, Sona has even less threats coming towards her. being engaged on is your weakness, so you have to be cautious about it, but your scaling and harass on lane is excellent, so as long as you don't fall too far behind, you're always going to be incredibly relevant in the later stages, and Sona's win rate at the moment completely reflects that. Effective use of your summoners is really important when playing Sona, as often your flash or exhaust will be the difference between a successful and unsuccessful all-in, so be sure not to waste them, but it is also vital to use them early when there is a kill threat and not wait until you're already dead to flash and die to the last tick of an ignite. And that's it for this patch, hopefully this has been helpful in getting you up to speed on the meta. If you're interested in seeing the full low elo and high elo list in one place, including C&D tiers, then head on over to mobalytics.gg where you can get even more info including counters, builds, tips, combos and more. See you next time and thanks for watching.